It's Linda MacPhee's workshop. Here's Linda.
Hi, and golly, it's tough playing that piano just on this table. But no, I love playing the piano, but I really do love sewing. And today's show, I've got some crazy stuff to show you because we're actually going to make something from nothing. It's one of my favorite topics. Nothing means a bunch of junk, a bunch of jeans. We'll show you how to create that into a one-of-a-kind garment, which I think is the way to go. That's why I sew. If I just wanted to go buy some stuff, I'd go buy it and look like everybody else. But if I could sew it, I don't look like everybody else. Maybe nobody else wants to look like this. I don't know. We'll bring you through this. Helping me with this is Corrine. So welcome to the show, Corrine.
Oh, thank you.
I mean, here we are in our workshop, the way we work every day. And this is work, remember?
Yes, so you keep telling me.
It's play, basically play. And that's the fun part, is that you get ideas
We're
from everything.
We're playing from the junk bags today, hey?
So this is junk bags.
Look at this.
Corrine does get after me every once in a while. Can I throw this away? And I'll say, no, you don't throw
anything.
No,
we have to keep, like, scraps this big.
She's, yes.
We have special bags for all the bags and bags. An embarrassment of scraps.
But clear bags, so you can
yes,
see them.
Yes, clear yeah. bags.
And I'm a bit insistent that you know where everything is. So we start out with a pair of actual jeans. It could be women's jeans. Do watch that you don't cut up an existing good pair. I mean, a fitting pair of jeans. You know, jeans shrink if you...
Yeah. You know, if you leave them in the closet too long, they do shrink.
Yes, but we don't want to, those are the ones we want to cut up. But the ones you're wearing, you'll get in big trouble if you cut up your husband's mm-hmm. good jeans or something. But you do need jeans. Actually, it's a new trick of mine. I say that's a good way to get everybody to pick up their clothes, because everything that's been on the floor for more than a week is fair game.
Oh.
You might go with that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I might.
So let's have a look at the jacket, shall we?
Okay.
Okay, here we go. So here is brown jeans. You can get all different colors of jeans, mm-hmm. and brown jeans are good. So we've used the pockets. Why would you ever make pockets, is my theory, if you can find pockets. So there's one pocket, and there's the other pocket on the other side. You got pockets here you didn't even know that you needed, and you got pockets on the back, and little bits of fabric pieces. And I think the highlight of this is these sleeves. You want to tell them what they are, Corrine?
I'll tell them. Yeah. Amazingly enough, like this, I'm sure this is a sleeve. It's not really pants.
It is
a sleeve. It's already made. It's already hemmed.
You just go into the stores and try on the legs, on your arms.
Yeah.
And there is a sleeve.
Hemmed, sewn.
Hemmed, everything.
Yeah.
So it's perfect. So that is one jacket. Let's have a look at the other one. Because it can be all colors. I mean, joyfully, you can buy red jeans, so why not red ones? So here's the sleeve, i.e. leg of the red jeans. You can see even the double seam and everything on there. But here's the pockets. We've got pockets here and here. And probably some pockets on the back and pockets wherever. And bits and pieces of fabric that kind of coordinates. And I thought this one needed a little bit of a collar, so we put a little bit of collar on there. And
really, we just took it from the junk bag and laid it on there and said, that's good, let's sew it on.
Yeah, yeah. So I think, I mean, I've had people offer me big bucks for this kind of stuff. So,
have you?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Thank you so much. So where do we start? We find, well, first of all, find a bunch of junk and sort of coordinate your junk.
Yeah, coordinate
your junk. I sort of think that there's a fine line between this and a clown suit. You know,
you do kind of have to watch.
Yeah, because you could be a little bit silly. And we do get a little bit silly.
Yep.
This one is going to be maybe a little bit bigger. Do you want to cut it? You're on the
right
side.
Sure, I'll cut it.
So there we go.
The sleeve has a front side and a back side, so fold it in half and just cut the fattest part here.
Yeah.
It's not really, it doesn't matter if it's not exact. It'll still go in the armhole.
Oh, yeah.
There.
The good news about this is close is good enough.
Yeah, yeah. And then we just cut out the front part like this. And do remember to cut a left and a right sleeve.
True enough, or you have to go buy some more jeans.
Yeah.
So here is going to be a new sleeve.
That works. If it's too wide, you can take it in.
Yeah. Or you could put some other kind of gadget on the bottom of that. So, yes.
Mm-hmm.
So, there we go. So, then how are we going to get the body?
Well, we started with an awesome jacket pattern and some cassia. Ooh.
Well, awesome. We should really explain. This is one of my patterns that I call it awesome because AWE stands for almost world's easiest.
That's a good
to
one.
Me, one piece body and one piece sleeve is about as easy as it's going to get.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's a great one for beginner sewers, for people who haven't done a whole lot. For those of us that have done a whole lot, it's even more fun too.
Yeah.
So it doesn't really matter. So I've used a good base. I mean, if you're going to stick all this stuff on something, it has to be firm. This is the cassia. It's flannel on one side, satin on the other. So this is going to be next to our body. It feels so nice. It just feels good. And the joy of it, shall we flip it?
Oh, we're good. We almost
did. Yeah. And then this is going to be flannel side up, so it mm-hmm. becomes like a big flannel board.
Yep.
So it was really meant to be. So then you can put all kinds of stuff all over it. And you decide what you want from all of this.
I like to start with the pockets, you know.
Pockets is the best place.
And then I can just tuck in underneath if I need to.
Yeah.
And I like the pockets to be kind of at the same level so that you're not going like this when you put your hands in.
That's true. I mean, the whole object of this is to make it look like you didn't make it.
Yes.
And
yes.
if the pockets are kind of, it might look a little bit
yeah,
like
yeah.
you.
It's nice to have them kind yeah. of the same level.
And I also think it's important not to match the pockets. You see, there's this curved pocket on this front, uh-huh. and there's the backpack. Patch pocket on this
yeah.
because if they match, then you sort of think, oh, we've got to measure fuss, sort of go into that old home ec-y kind of mode yeah. that you used to worry about. And no, that's not fun. Can I just grab those scissors?
Of course, cut.
Because my favorite fabrics to use on here are fabrics that don't fray. So if I have a piece like this, this is fleece, and of course it doesn't fray. This is something I can put wherever I find a mess.
Here's a mess.
Okay, well here's a mess too. Yeah. So I could put that right there. I could put another piece over there. You can then pin this down and just stitch it. But there's lots of other ways of covering. You've got a piece here you could do something with.
Sometimes we do braid over top of the edge. We love this fabric, but it does fray.
Yeah.
So we just cover the edge with braid.
Although sometimes letting the fabric fray is okay too.
Yeah.
So that would work.
I don't know. You can pin this on, but really your fingers get tired after a while.
Okay, so here we go with, we could put some twill tape on mm-hmm. that. The other thing, you do put lots of pins, but I do have this little trick. If you're deciding you don't want to pin everything, and I know we are scared to show this, but you could staple things on.
You could.
You'd rather take the staples out.
You have to take the staples
yeah,
out.
Yeah, for sure.
We have this tape.
Yes,
we
have the tape too, which works really well. You take that and I'll find something that you could...
This is.
That works beautifully.
If I can find the beginning, there it is. This is leather tape. We use it when we're making leather garments. But
so here, put it on that.
Put it on the back side.
Yeah. And the joy of it is that it pulls right off. It gives you glue exactly where you want it.
Take the paper off.
Yeah. And then put it down, and it's going to stay.
Yeah.
And I also put it back where it's not going to be stitched, so you're not going to stitch through it because your machine kind of fusses a little bit stitching through that. So you basically sew all this stuff on.
Lay it all out. Sew yeah. it on.
There's one little trick, though, I must remind you, is that sometimes we get carried away and we put the nice big circle right here. Not good. No, you don't want to be... I mean, just don't do it.
Yeah.
Just avoid, and even on the back side, you don't want a great big circle on the behind, too.
You don't.
So let's not
go
there.
Oh, don't forget our sleeves.
Sleeves are yeah. that. Okay. So now we're sewing it together.
So we've sort of gone along here. Oh, upside down.
Doesn't matter.
There.
Okay. So here we have all this stuff stitched down. We have the sleeve in.
Mm-hmm.
We have the zipper. We sew one side down, do it up, sew the other side. I like this little treatment because we've put just a folded piece of the lining in as yeah. we stitch that.
Yeah, sometimes you get a lot of
yeah.
stuff here.
And then what happens is that when that comes back and top stitches, that's going to be all covered. The edge of the zipper, so neat and so tidy. People, I mean, if they're going to pay you big bucks, you want to do it nicely.
It should be tidy on the other
side. So that is going to be top stitched. You've got a collar that will easily go on here.
Mm-hmm.
And this is all ready to sandwich right over top, so you can put it right over top. That'll cut away, and that will sandwich over the top. Like, actually, you want this side, I guess, on this side, don't
yeah.
you?
Yeah. And you can stitch that other side down by hand yeah. or by machine.
Yeah.
It's up
yeah.
to you.
So that will finish that. You've got another real good trick for the sleeve, though. I thought
yeah.
it was so good.
Yeah, if you plan it right and put your sleeve in the right way, you put your jean sleeve in first.
This is the only raw edge so far that's
yeah.
really looking raw.
And then you put
hand
this...
Hand stitch or machine stitch?
Machine stitch. You can set it up.
Wait, yeah.
I think this one is done.
You'd actually put... Just getting back to this. You'd actually put... the right sides to the right sides, and sew that
as
on this side.
As you would a regular sleeve.
And, of course, it'll flip over,
yeah.
which you've got the one done there, so it looks so neat on that side as well.
All lined.
So that could be actually reversible. Oh, let's not even go there.
Okay,
I think we did it, and I hope that you've had fun.
Oh, it is.
I mean, this is... Everyone's different. And I hope you've enjoyed us, because we're kind of crazy, and you can be kind of crazy, too, and there's no rules to this one, so go and have some fun. But don't go away. We've got to have some more good stuff coming up right after this. It's a beautiful, sunny Saturday afternoon, and my favorite place in the summertime is to find a farmer's market. So I found the farmer's market here in St. Albert. This is the largest farmer's market in Western Canada, and I'm just cruising around to see who I can find, and I have stumbled upon the jackpot right now, because Helen is here. Hello, Helen.
Hi there.
And you then raise these goats.
We raise Angora goats. We have about 75 of them.
Okay.
And we have our farms just northwest of Edmonton.
Yes. So you raise them for their fiber.
You raise them for their mohair. You have to shear them twice a year, once in the spring, once in the fall.
Okay. And then from that fiber, you can do all kinds
you
of...
You can do else
the,
all kinds
yes,
of
how about this?
These
this
are both hives.
This is a departed one.
Yes.
But that's what happens, I guess, is that...
Every now and then.
Yes, okay. But is that not gorgeous? That would look very beautiful on one of my coats and one of these things.
A lot of people have been using them for the backs of chairs.
True.
Little
yeah.
rugs.
Yeah, the natural fiber.
Wall hangings.
That would make
yeah.
great hair for those Santa Claus guys, all that kind
yes,
of stuff.
Yes, yeah. And we do sell our mohair for that.
Okay. So the fiber, what does the fiber look like? Have you got some here?
Yeah.
Okay.
We have this kind of...
This is what happens when you shear.
This is you shear them.
And you get these nice little curly things.
You get these curls. If you ever see any kind of really expensive Father Christmases,
yeah.
that's
what
they all use that. If you've got porcelain dolls, they use mohair for that.
Okay.
Has so lots of different
do you
uses.
Card this then and make it?
You just basically, this is just washed. We want to keep all of the curls.
Yeah, yeah.
Just
but
as
I'm
they
thinking
are.
When you go to this array of wonderful things, how do you do that?
This is carded. And okay. it is made into felting bats, and then all we do is we either wet felt it
yes,
to make pieces of material, and then you make traditionally stuffed animals.
Yes, I mean the expression.
I'm really lucky here. I have neighbors who are professional felters as well as professional seamstresses.
It's a team.
So they
it's
do
a team.
That. It is.
Yeah, that's great.
These needle felted. Guys,
they're fascinating.
Those are ones
me.
I
yes.
do.
We had a guest on our show a couple of seasons ago that was doing needle felting, and it's just, in fact, you've got some here, haven't you? Didn't I see you doing that to begin with?
Yes.
Isn't this what you're...
So right now I'm going to be making a little, we're not too sure exactly what he's going to be, but he's going
he's
to have very long legs.
Legs, yeah. And this is going to be the body. This is
And
how
that's his body.
And you'll sew it all together then.
And then he's going to be jointed, so we'll be able
and
to...
And your implements that you're using are just these needles.
That's a felting needle.
And you just sort of poke them, is that...
That's right.
Am I right?
And the more that you poke it, you can feel how hard this
yes,
is.
Yes, it is. Yeah, yeah. And it just cements it a little bit more each time.
That's right.
It?
Yeah. yeah.
Oh, I love this idea. In fact, I was kind of looking around the corner here and see this one already in the bag. I said, is this one sold? Because this one's so beautiful. It shouldn't be in the bag. It can't breathe. You know that. So there.
Everybody here is named.
Oh, and what's...
So his name, I figured that he looked like a little French guy, and so his name is Alain.
Oh, yes. I think he might have to sit on my mantle. I love dolls. Those are just... Beautiful. So we'll just kind of leave him out. He's been in his plastic bag long enough. You were saying, how do you get the colors on these things? Goats don't come colored.
No, but one of the mohair has two really wonderful qualities. One is that it takes color really, really well. So if you take a look at any of our animals here, the colors are very vibrant.
Yes.
The other really nice quality that mohair has is that it has kind of a real luster to it. So if you look at any of the hides or if you look at any of the animals, they have kind of a sheen to them.
Mm-hmm.
And that is the mohair.
Okay. You indicated that you could use hair dye as the same kind of stuff that we use.
I've used everything from Kool-Aid
okay.
to Miss Clairol to weak acid dyes.
Okay, okay.
So you can do all kinds of really neat things.
Fascinating. Well, thank you for this, Helen. I'm fascinated. I've just got to keep looking around here. I just
well, thank
love
you
it.
Very
so
much.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Yes. Good enough. It's great to get out and about, and I had such fun at that farmer's market. In fact, we're going to be bringing you other segments from the market because I saw some more exciting people. But you know, we've got to take a break. We're going to come right back because I've got some more exciting stuff. We're back with the recycling because I love denim and I love everything that you can do with it. And I found another person who's as in love with it as I am in Joan Statz. So it's great to have you back on the show. We've had
Thanks
you before.
For having me. Yeah.
You do the magnificent landscapes.
Landscapes, yes.
And you've been doing this for a lot of years.
Yes, I have.
You've done your patterns. It just keeps going and going.
It does.
It?
It does.
Yeah,
it does.
Wonderful. So I know that this is something you did a while back because you said, oh, Linda, don't make me bring that. And I said, yes, This is such a wonderful thing because this is your quilt. Wasn't there a story that you're...
This is for the teenagers.
Yes.
I had a son who wore out every blanket or duvet we bought him, so I thought, this is indestructible.
It is.
What teenager doesn't like denim? Actually, denim is the universal fabric of the world,
I would say.
I think denim goes everywhere.
So you then, how did you, this actually, there's a system to this, isn't there?
Well, there is in a way. I started with a basic square and a piece of muslin, and you just keep building old patch pockets. What's kind of fun about this is I actually made all the children's blue jeans when they were growing up, so I've actually recycled my own...
Your own work.
Work, yes.
Oh, that is
Some of
ultimate.
It is bought jeans, but a lot of it are jeans that I have made.
Yes,
so, because when you've gone to the work of making jeans, you don't want to just throw them out.
Exactly.
So it's kind of nice that they get a second life.
So
I started with muslin, and you just cut out pieces that you find interesting and lay them down. But denim is quite big, and it's heavy, so you don't want to do that all in one huge piece.
No.
Because if you've ever done crazy patch, you know eventually you kind of run out of corners.
Yes.
So I thought, well, I'll do a square, and then I'll do some triangles.
And you put a sort of a border around it.
Join them with like a waistband type looking piece.
Yes.
And I even did the quilting with a denim top stitching thread, so it looks more authentic. And then the borders around the very edge are just basically four strips, and the corners are quite plain. They just added on. So that way, you're only crazy patching a section at a time.
Yes.
And then you put it together.
Yes.
And I've only quilted on those borders.
Okay.
I just didn't think the denim needed to be quilted that much.
Yeah.
And there is no batting in here.
No, it's heavy enough.
It's heavy enough.
Yeah,
and the kids have fought over this now because I've only done this one big one. And every one of them say, well, when I leave home, I'm taking the denim quilt.
I guess it could
We're
be more
have
than
to
one.
We're going to have a lottery or
yes,
something.
Yes, 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 yes. No, I think that's a great thing. And again, you could abuse this thing.
Oh,
completely.
It's been washed and dried.
Yeah,
and I mean, you can throw in pillows, so we have quite a few pillows. Actually, for teenagers that want to learn to sew, it's a great idea. It's a simple project. They can recycle their blue jeans and make their own pillows to go in their room.
Sure.
Very
sure.
versatile. So it's great for
okay,
them.
Okay, I think that is fantastic. So that was what I wanted to show, first of all.
Then you have lots more little leftovers.
So this is what happens when you get carried away with your leftovers. And I love the whole monochromatic thing.
Yes, and there was a contest that I wanted to enter, and the contest was texturing. So I had to use different mediums, like brushing it and crinkling it.
So this, you've just put little pieces on and taken a wire brush to it?
Actually, a vacuum hose. And that way you kind of brush it
and
get rid of the
lids
of the lids? Same thing.
Yeah, there's a good idea. So you
but I did this twice because I wasn't thinking. I stitched all these denim leaves on in regular denim. Well, you know denim, it's woven with white.
Yes.
So when I brushed it, the leaves all turned white. And I thought, oh, it's so good.
Yeah.
And my rule is, if it keeps you from sleeping, you have to pick it out in the morning. Well, that night I tossed and turned thinking, I didn't want a snow picture. So I got up in the morning and I took off all the leaves and I found denim woven blue with blue.
Blue with blue,
and put
okay.
it on, which was a lot better.
Yes.
But it was kind of fun. In those times, I couldn't find a sky fabric, so I actually took spray dye and sprayed this.
Okay.
The sun has sort of faded the color a little bit.
Yeah.
But wherever I got a blob of dye, I stitched a bird. And I would have never done the birds without the mistake, so I was glad.
Yeah, and that so often happens, is that something creates a thought,
exactly.
and then you have to cover, and you
exactly.
go up from there.
The little barn and the houses are made with pleated fabric, so this is actually a lightweight chambray, because, you know, if you ever tried to pleat denim, you would end up with it.
Yeah,
this
you
thick.
Couldn't do that.
So it's just pleated fabric, because I wanted it to look like siding.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, it was a contest, and I was determined.
Did you win the contest?
Yes. I was aiming for second place because second place was thread, and I really love thread, but I got first place, which is great.
It was doggone.
No complaining. No complaining. These are just little three-dimensional flowers that are made, you know, by zigzagging around them.
Yeah.
There's
yeah.
stiffener in there to keep it from...
Okay, so you would have done them and then cut them out, is what
actually,
you would do?
I cut them out and glued them onto Solvy, you
okay,
know, the Solvy
yes,
stabilizer,
yeah.
then zigzagged around them, and then when I rinsed them, the stabilizer actually, it stayed in there and made them stiff.
Yeah.
This was just yarn that I knotted and stitched around to make the knot stick
Yeah, you
down.
Did good texture because this is all just kind of pleated in and kind of just scrunched in.
Yeah, just fun. And then there was some fringe I found for the horse's mane and tail. And then I found this blue rope and I thought, well, why not make little belt loops with buttonholes and feed it through to make the fence.
The fence.
But you know what? Since I moved to the country, Linda, I've learned that there's no such thing as a black cow with white spots.
But the artist in you said you could... could be that. That's okay.
I did. I thought the black cow would show up better with white spots.
Yeah. So now you understand that they're white with black. So whatever.
Yes, I've learned a lot since I moved to the country.
That is good. But and this, you put your fusible behind and just scrunched it all up.
Exactly. But I think the most important part about doing a denim wall hanging is the value of the denims. You need to get your colors, lights to darks, because we all think of denim as being one faded color.
Yes.
Yep. But if you take blue jeans, for example, you can get them in different shades of denim. And you need the light and the medium and the dark in order to create your picture. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, it's just flat seams.
Yes. The more, the better,
yes.
I'm saying.
And if you want a true dark denim, I would stick with new denim.
The unwashed.
Yeah. And actually, these jeans all started out as this denim.
Okay.
And it's just a matter of wear and bleaching and age that creates the different colors.
Well, I think it's so amazing to think that you have actually done the blue jeans to begin with. I mean, this is no slouch. This woman knows her stuff. So you made the blue jeans, washed them, bleached them, did whatever, and then... Yeah.
All to please the teenagers. I don't get it.
What a good mom. You're a good mom. So lighter weights, of course.
Chambray.
Yeah,
chambray
yeah.
is wonderful for doing your texturing because it's not as heavy, and you can do a lot with chambray. And chambray comes in all the colors that denim comes in, too.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Chambray is
so
great.
You're going to then just look for as many scraps and pieces. This is the kind of time you'd go to your local... recycle store or whatever.
Yes, and, your recycle store or your neighbor's closets, because everybody's got blue jeans they don't want to throw out, but they don't know what to do
and
with.
The more colors, the better. You could, I suppose, start dyeing, but you really didn't have to, because in this case, you had as many as you needed.
I did. I had as many as I needed just from what I had.
I have found, because I have gone to those kinds of stores looking for denim, and then some sweet little lady comes up and she says, well, you know, in the back, dear, we have these big garbage bags full of denim jeans that are not wearable. And, I mean, for $5, you get a great big bag.
I have found there's no shortage of people willing to give you their denim jeans, their old jeans.
Yes. Yeah, no, this is great. I love particularly these. I just noticed them now, those little sheep.
Well, then what that is, it's a jogging fleece that was blue. That's the wrong side.
Okay.
And I just stippled it to me, and then just stitched the little legs and the little hair.
And basically, you've just gone around all this. You've fused it all down the way you would normally.
The way I normally fuse it and sew it. Because I like a fast method. Yes, I don't like to take all day.
And you haven't used decorative stitches because the fabric itself speaks for itself.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. There was no need for any decorative stitches.
All right, that is good. Well, let me see. You have been doing some other things.
Yes, I have been. I have been doing a few things, such as rug making.
Yes, because you happen to have quite a few scraps.
I do. That's
one
thing.
That's why you moved.
Okay. I have collected a lot of scraps. And I've been trying to come up with an idea for rugs for quite a while. And I decided what... The thing was what do you stuff it with? What makes it thick? So I found this piping cord, which is wonderful. And all I do is I take cotton fabric, rip it into 1-inch wide strips, and just start wrapping it around. Mm-hmm. And as you wrap it, you just use a triple zigzag, and you just stitch around.
This is all machine done. Oh, I like
it. It's all machine. This take you one evening to do this rug, which is wonderful.
Ooh.
The only little thing you have to watch is it's almost like knitting. You need a little tension.
Yes.
Because if you pull on it, you're going to end up with a
bowl.
Big bowl.
And the bowl is okay, too.
The bowl is okay, too. And you can really shape bowls, like baskets. To get this one flat bottom.
Just about time.
Okay.
Well, no, I can see we're going to have you on another show. And you're into now blankets?
Yes, we're going to make afghans.
Yeah. Oh, we'll do that next time.
Wonderful.
Yeah, thank you so much for being with us today. This has inspired me more. Old denim is good. Of all denim is...
Denim is wonderful.
Denim is great. So, okay, thank you so much, Joan. We've got to go. Watch us next time on Linda MacPhee's Workshop.
To receive the companion book for this series, send 1998 to the address on your screen or call 1-888-MacPhee.